Hello everyone. In today's lecture, we are going to start with three-phase bridge inverter. This is the topic of unit number 3, DC to AC converters. In our previous lecture, we have seen single-phase full bridge inverter for resistive load and for inductive load. We have also seen PWM inverter. In this lecture, we are going to cover following subtopics. We are going to start with a basic introduction about three-phase inverter. Then we are going to see three-phase VSI, voltage source inverter for R load. Then we are going to see harmonic elimination method. Myself, Professor Amit Kumar Mishra, I am having total 10 years of teaching experience and my domain expertise is of 10 years. Let's start with three-phase voltage source inverter for resistive load. This figure is of three-phase voltage source inverter. It consists of 6 thyristors starting from T1 to T6. The important thing in this circuit is positioning of the thyristors. You can see over here, thyristor T1 is here, T2 is here, T3 is here, then T4, T5, and then T6. This is very important. So the positioning of the thyristor should be as it is shown in this figure. It is a voltage source inverter, so the input will be voltage source VS, and it's a three phase, so three phase are there, phase A, phase B, and phase C. Now how the load has been connected, you can see over here, this is phase A, this is phase B, and this is phase C. We can either connect a star load or we can either connect a delta load. In this figure, we have connected a star load. Now this is phase A, so the resistance, this will be RA. This is phase B, so the resistance will be RB. And this is phase C, so resistance will be RC. We will assume that RA is equal to RB is equal to RC, that is equal to R. This three-phase voltage source inverter operates in two modes. One is 180 degree mode and second one is 120 degree mode. Let's see 180 degree mode first. We are going to do the calculation also, but just we will to understand in better way, we will see this graph. See, this is 180 degree mode. So each device is going to conduct for 180 degree. You can see this is the trigger angle, trigger current IG1 for thyristor 1. One mode is of 60 degrees, so there are three modes, 60 plus 60 plus 60. So this device, first device, is going to trigger for 180 degree. After that, there will be no signal over here for next 180 degree. That means our one cycle is from here to here. Then again, next cycle is starting at this point. Again, thyristor 2 will be triggered for 180 degree, 60 plus 60 plus 60. Similarly, third thyristor will be triggered for 180 degree. Our cycle is completed at this point. So if we see this, the next thing is between each thyristor, there will be an angle delay of 60 degree. Means second device will be triggered after 60 degree only. Now, thyristor 4 will be triggered for 180 degrees, that is 60 plus 60 plus 60. Now thyristor 5, our cycle is completed over here. So 60 plus 60, and then our cycle will come over here, so 60, so total 180 degree. From this, next cycle is coming. So if we see from here to here, that means this 60, 60 and 60. Now, sixth thyristor, so this cycle will be shifted 60 degree and rest of the two, that is 60 plus 60, 120 will be coming on this side. So total for this cycle, one cycle, 60, 60 and this 60, 180 degree. Now, how to do the calculation for VAB, VBC and VCA. So this calculation will be done mode wise. If we see this, this is mode 1, this is mode 2, this is mode 3. In mode 1, first thyristor, fifth thyristor and sixth thyristor is triggered. That means only three thyristors will be on in mode 1. That is IG1. Thyristor 1, thyristor 5 and thyristor 6. And based on that, we will do the calculation of magnitude of VAB, VBC and VCA. Let's see how. This is the waveform for VAN, VBN, and VCN. What is VAN? This is voltage of phase 1 with respect to neutral. This is voltage for phase B with respect to neutral. And this is voltage for C with respect to neutral. And what is VAB, VBC, and VCA? VAB is the voltage between phase A and phase B. VBC is the voltage between phase B and phase C. And VCA is the voltage between phase C and phase A. So we will see mode 1. Mode 1 means what? This mode. In our case, in this mode, thyristor 1, 5, and 6 are triggering. Means on. So for mode 1 operation, if we see the main circuit, this one, so mode 1, thyristor 1, thyristor 5, and thyristor 6 are on. How we are getting this? So you can see the waveform. Mode 1, thyristor 1, thyristor 5, and thyristor 6 is on. So if you see this circuit, thyristor 1, thyristor 5, and thyristor 6 are on. That means this phase A is connected with the positive of the battery, positive of the input source. Phase C is going to connected with the positive of the input source. And phase B is going to connect with the negative of the input source. That means these phases, phase A, phase B, and phase C are later on connected with the resistance. Initially, it is RA, RB, and RC. Therefore, two resistance, RA and RC, is connected with the positive of the input source, and RB is connected with the negative of the input source. So, two resistance, RA and RB, RC, is connected with the positive of the input source, and RB is connected with the negative of the input source. We have to assume that RA is equal to RB is equal to RC, that is equal to R. So we have not written over here RA, RB, or RC. We have written R only. Now, how to do the calculation? First of all, we have to find out the equivalent resistance of this circuit. So what is R equivalent? R equivalent will be 3R by 2. Now, what is the main current, which is I1? That will be source, input source upon equivalent resistance. So that will be 2Vs upon 3R. Now, what is VAN, means voltage at this point? So that will be current which is flowing through this into resistance. Now, this current is divided into two parts, here and here. So voltage from VA to N, that means VAN will be what? I1 R by 2. I1 R by 2. So what is I1? We have to substitute from here. R will get cancelled. So we are going to get VAN is equal to VS by 3. In the same way, VCN. So that will be also same. So that is VS by 3. Now what is VBN? So it is minus of I1 R. Why it is minus of I1 R? Because the same current is flowing from this side. And it is going to the negative of the voltage source. So that will be negative. And here no division or partition of the current is taking place as it was taking over here. So it is minus of I1 into resistance R. Now what is I1? So it is 2Vs upon 3R into R. So it is minus of 2Vs upon 3. Similarly, in mode 2, if you see the waveform in mode 2, this is mode 2. This was mode 1. So in mode 2, thyristor 1, thyristor 2, and thyristor 6 are triggered or it is on. So based on that, we have to find out the equivalent circuit. And from there, here in mode 1, A was there, and here C was there, and here B was there. In mode 2, here it is B, C, and A. So it is based on the thyristors which are on. For the reference, you can see in mode 1 how we have taken or how we have drawn the equivalent circuit. So this resistance will be RB, this resistance will be RC, this resistance will be RA. Now RA is equal to RC is equal to RB, that is equal to R. So how to do the calculation of VBN, VCN, and VAN? So VAN is equal to, this is positive terminal of the battery, so directly I2R. So 2Vs upon 3. What is VBN? VBN is equal to VCN, that is equal to minus of I1R upon 2. Why minus? Minus of I2R upon 2. Minus is because negative terminal. These two resistances are connected with the negative terminal. Y2 because current, this I2 is coming over here and getting divided between the two parts. And resistance means the resistance over here. So we are talking about the voltage for this path. So resistance of this path will be taken. We are talking about the resistance voltage of this path, VCN. So resistance of this path will be taken. Therefore, we are going to get VAN is equal to 2VS upon 3. VBN is equal to VCN, that is equal to minus of VS upon 3. Similarly, we can do the calculation for mode 3 also. Now, you might be noticing this part in every mode. What is this? So you can see in mode 1 is from 0 to 60 degree. Pi by 3 means 60. Mode 2 is from 60 to next 60, that means 120 degree. And mode 3 is from 120 to 180 degree, means each mode is of 60 degree. In the same way, we have shown that in waveform also. So here 0 to 60, mode 2 is from 60 to 120, and mode 3 is from 120 to 180 degree. Now, this voltage, three phase voltage source inverter operate in two modes. One is 180 degree mode, second one is 120 degree mode. So we have just seen 180 degree mode. Now, once for each mode, we are getting the value of VAN, VBN and VCN. Same we are going to plot over here. The magnitude what we are getting for each mode, we have to draw that. Once we have drawn for VAN, VBN and VCN, then what we have to do is we have to draw for VAB, VBC and VCA. How to calculate VAB? VAB is VA minus VB, means VAN minus VBN. So what is VAN? So magnitude in one mode of VAN, magnitude of the VBN in the same mode. So if we do the subtraction of these two for mode 1, then we are going to get the magnitude of VAB in mode 1. Similarly for VBC and VCA, and for each mode we have to perform the same and we have to plot in the graph. So we are going to get this kind of graph for 180 degree mode. Now let's see how this device is going to operate in 120 degree mode. The circuit diagram is going to remain same for voltage source inverter for 120 degree mode. The only change will be in the graph. In 120 degree mode, each device is going to trigger for 120, that means for two mode. Here it is 60, 60. Here it is 60, 60, 60, 60. So, till this, there is one cycle. Each device is going to operate or trigger for 60 degree. Now, mode 1 is for 60 degree. So, in mode 1, only two devices going to trigger or on. That is device thyristor 1 and thyristor 6. In mode 2, again two device will on, that is thyristor 1 and thyristor 2. In mode 3, again two device will remain on, that is more thyristor 2 and thyristor 3. So the calculation we have to do in the same way what we have done for 180 degree mode. And then we are going to calculate, we have to draw equivalent circuit for each mode. From there, we have to find out VAN, VBN, and VCN. And after doing that, then we have to go with VAB, VBO, and VC, VAB, VBC, and VCA. So we are going to get this kind of graph, what you are seeing on the screen. The only difference is here, we have to trigger the device for 120 degree mode only. That means for two mode, this and this mode. In this second thyristor, this and this mode. Next is harmonics elimination or modulation techniques. The selected harmonics as per our choice can be eliminated using this PWM technique. You can see over here, this is PWM signal, means a signal is having is of pulse of different width. Methods of harmonic elimination. So there are two methods mainly. One is harmonic injected modulation and second is third harmonic PWM. Harmonic injected modulation. Here you can see there is a reference wave and there is a carrier signal. So this is the output voltage what we are getting. The advantage of this scheme are higher amplitude of fundamental component and second is low distortion. Next method for harmonic elimination is third harmonic PWM. This is the waveform for that. Third harmonic PWM provides better utilization of DC power supply voltage than in SPWM. In this lesson, we have learned three-phase VSI inverter for R load in 180 degree and 120 degree mode. Second is harmonic reduction using PWM techniques. Thank you.